I'm on top and he's grabbing onto my love handles.
I just thought you were actually
just a little dough ball. Wait, love handles are awesome.
A little boxing, man. Let's get it.
Any comment on that? You're just going to be a silent podcast guest.
Hold on a second.
Y'all,
I came up and I showed up for your podcast.
Ladies and gentlemen, Gary Bertrand.
Okay, I'm
that's
sorry.
Just walked into the building. Yo, why don't you ask me some hard-hitting fucking questions, bro?
You guys, I'm just...
When's the last time you had a fucking threesome?
I've never had a threesome. Oh, no, that was good.
This was such an idea.
All right.
Okay.
When's the last time you had a cheeseburger?
Okay.
Beef and stew, dude. Ask
okay.
Me some shit, not where she finds her fucking memes, dude.
Well, I'm just going to because the credit thing is a big deal. A lot of people get really mad over that. And you've stolen some of my content without credit.
Fat Jewish.
What?
Famous example. Fat Jewish.
Yeah,
famous
you came under fire for
major fucking fire. Sorry,
yeah.
I just woke up. I'm here, folks. Right?
Yep.
Mike's fat fucking
there we go.
Jewish.
Mike's here.
Major problem. Didn't credit his creators. Almost lost his fucking shit because of it. Got in a lot of trouble for it. One of the most famous meme pages of all time. Do you credit your creators? And if you don't, and
the
if you
fat
do,
Jewish got in
why
trouble.
Don't you?
The fat Jewish got in trouble a few years ago because it wasn't about stealing memes. It was he was taking content of actual comedians or comedians are trying to grow as comedians from Twitter, and he was taking their jokes and not crediting the comedians. That's where he started to get heat from a bunch of comedians, and that's where he started like the whole thing started. But a lot of times, I create my own memes. And like people take off my watermark or people steal it, and I personally don't get upset because I know in the end of the day it's already on the internet. There's nothing I can do, and I know it's more to make people happy, to make people laugh. But I also understand if you are a struggling comedian or if you're trying to be funny and you think it's gonna help you. Like I understand where it's coming from, and of course I will always want to be able to give credit. Secondly, the reason why I'm coming off awkwardly or whatever, like I guess totally I get it if I have anxiety, but. I came on this podcast because I thought I was gonna get more like into deep conversations. Like I started that, it's just not that. So no, it's fine. So I wasn't. So I guess like
so
I
you
wasn't
had an expectation. You set an expectation for this for our show.
No, I mean,
well,
Dubai.
You did.
But like I guess I wasn't going to like talk about like a bunch of sex because I do know you guys talk about sex like a lot on your podcast. So I just
I
wasn't
Mike's
expecting
only asked
to
you one question.
Let's stop.
Why not? Mike's only
asked
you one question. Okay, stop. I just, before this podcast started, I showed Mike a clip of him just trying to interject.
Yeah, because you're sucking ass on today's podcast, right? You're not doing that. I'm trying
to
jump in here.
I don't think so. I think Mike talks about sex a lot, and so far on this podcast, I think we've only brought up one thing about sex, two things. Our past hookup little situation, and Mike asked you once if you had a threesome. So, like, I also think you may be going down a path that we aren't going, and are skewing what we're saying. Like,
no.
Like we just talked about communist Russia for a second. Where's that in the highlights of Violet Benson?
Okay.
We could have talked about communist sex, but we didn't.